fallen god, creator and destroyer of worlds, hear my vow. Hear my vow. My vow of defiance. See, you've heard me.
The monastery's ahead. I wonder if it is still safe.
Either way, our quest for Antanas nears a conclusion.
I hope he's worth all the men we've lost on our way here.
It's locked.
You're still losing blood, Caslow. The Rogar got you good.
I didn't let you out of prison to worry about me.
You're no use to me if you bleed to death.
I will try to spare you the inconvenience of my death.
There must be some way to open this door.
A switch, perhaps, or a key.
These things keep coming. We fight back, but there are too many of them. It is sickening to see them move. Their limbs twist and turn in ways they're not supposed to. And their smell. It's like fire and death creeping up your nose. One of the creatures we were fighting spat. Saliva hit my eyes. It burned. It burns deeper into me.
in me, and it is changing me. My skull, the bones are moving, growing. It does not feel like poison in my veins, more like liquid darkness. We have seen with others what happens next. Eyesight goes first, then follows sanity. Brother Wilmer, Brother Peter and I won't let the disease take us. We will choose death.
Dear Father, the fires on the horizon, they are spreading towards our village. I beg you, be careful. Something evil is happening. I can feel it. You can always seek refuge here, in the monastery. Whatever happens, Antanas can save us. Please, please, be safe.
Found a key. What are you waiting for? Open the door. I could use some help. Here, this might be useful.
One of those lords Kazlo keeps talking about.
Soon after banishing the god, the three men that were known as the Judges parted ways forever. Apart from their common goal, they were very different in every possible way. Three statues were built for them on the square of the Judges, displaying the distinct paths they had taken. These statues hold a secret, as if it were their heart, but it is retained by the stone. Only the Shard of Heroes could make that heart. And only an unearthly force could tear it out.
What exactly were the Lords? They wielded power beyond our understanding. They fought fiercely, and they blindly followed the god. They tried to talk to them, reason, failed. The Lords did not come to discussion. They came to serve their purpose. To lead the Rogar army against the humans.
You! Help me! Please!
What happened to your hand?
Spider venom! It burns like Adir himself touched it!
Rip the wound and suck the poison out.
Too late! It already spread!
There's only one way to stop the venom. Separate the poisoned limb from the body.
You want me to cut my arm off? You're a madman!
You'll see the judges soon, then.
I can't. I won't. It's in your hands.
All right. On your head be it.
Thank you. I owe my life to you, stranger. Wait. You're not one of the monastics. The markings on your face.
A gift from the court. A reminder of my sins.
Please, put the axe down now.
You need someone to patch you up. You won't hold long in this state.
I am the healer monk here. And yes, I see the irony of the situation.
You must have supplies.
I do. They're in the laboratory, but the place is full of Rogar beasts. It's no use. I won't make it there in this condition.
Here, take this one. As if one wasn't enough.
Mighty Antanas, my research is over. I dare to claim that this gauntlet does only one thing, but it does it rather well. It eats hatred like a hungry lion and spits it out like a dragon spits fire. Its bearer can wield it like a horrible weapon, but his soul must not be pure. A shattered soul will make the most out of this device.
This doesn't concern you.
Don't mind me then.
Ah!